He was not alive, but he was making noises. All the things you do, all the things you do, all the things you do. All the things you do, all the things you do, all the things you do. The good, the bad, the ugly, and I want to really get into it. Alright, so let's get started. The reason why I actually went into CNA school was because I love helping elderly patients. A lot of the residents, they are in nursing homes or rehabilitations, probably cannot care for themselves anymore and have family actually busy and end up putting them into the home, or there's a medical reason behind why they cannot go home. Becoming a CNA, I started taking the course at a nursing home. I believe the program was about 3 months, and the only thing was that when you finish, you'd stay there and work for them at least a year, and you don't have to pay for anything. I probably stayed there for about a month and then I left. I honestly felt like we were underpaid for all the work that we did. I ended up leaving. They never really billed me or anything for the program. CNA job is not an easy job. There's days where you're going to want to quit. You're going to want to go ahead and walk out. You're going to want to cry. You're going to be so stressed out and emotionally and physically tired that you're going to realize that either you're in it or you're not. Very physically demanding and emotionally, I feel like sometimes you get really attached to patients. I got really, really attached to most of my patients. It's very physically demanding because you got to be able to transfer patients the correct way. There are certain ways that you need to transfer patients. There are some patients that need more than one or two assists, meaning you need 1 to 2 people or more. And they'll have it by their bed, or the nurses will let you know which patient needs more than one person to transfer safely. So you got to be prepared for horrendous smells. Like, I'm talking about out of this world smells. You're going to be dealing with isolation patients that have wounds, that have need to be isolated for. They got some type of infection, MRSA. They got so many things that you gotta have to be prepared for the smells. A lot of patients come in with wounds. A lot of patients come in with bed sores. A lot of patients come in with massive infections, gangrene. So those are not some very pleasant smells. But once you work in a nursing home, you kind of get numb to them, if I can say. Like, it didn't really bother me after, but some of them are really bad where they penetrate into your clothes. So that's one of the bad things about it. One of the emotional things that really affected me was the patients that were on hospice. And you know, their time was coming, they just didn't know when. So I did experience that. My shift was 8 to 5, the other shift will start at 7, right before me. So they will start the breakfast for the patients. And I did notice that when I came in and did my rounding, when I first arrived every morning, so I had a whole hallway to myself, and I was checking on all my patients, and I saw one of my patients with his head down. His food was still untouched, so he didn't even eat breakfast, and he was a feeder, so I was already thinking nobody fed my patient. So then I go and I tap on him to let him know, to see if he's awake, basically. And I notice that there's a lot of red liquid on his gown. I said he's very cold when I touch him, and he had already passed away. And I guess nobody realized that. So then what we did at that point was we had to report it to the nurse. The nurse would come and check them, and then obviously we were responsible for cleaning up the patient, tagging the patient with on the toe with the name tag, and wrapping the patient in the sheet, so when the morgue came, we would have them ready. So that was a very hard part for me, and the first time that happened, I really got scared because he started making noises. He was not alive, but he was making noises. And you know, another bad thing was the patients that did stuff on purpose. That was like the ugly to me, because some of these patients did this to just get on your nerves. Oh my God, I swear he did this on purpose. So I showered him, got him clean and everything. He got shaved. He would come to me like not even 20 minutes later. He'll be like, Stephanie. I'm like, yes. He's like, can I get another shower? I'm like, what do you need another shower for? I showered you this morning. He'll be like, I want another shower. I'm like, no. He's like, okay, all right, I'm gonna get another shower. And I was like, okay, what do you mean? And then he's like, I'm like, you can ask the second shift when they come back, because I just showered you. You're clean. Like, you don't need a shower unless you, you know, had an accident. He's like, no, I didn't. I just wanted a shower. So then I'll be like, no, like, you can't get another shower. And it's not that I didn't want to, but it's just that you have a lot of duty to complete daily and you really don't have time to be getting out of schedule. So I told him that I would ask if the second shift could do it for him. He said no, he wanted it now. So what he actually did, and I'm sorry, this is very graphic, he stood up, he put his hand in his pants, he had poop, he had boo-booed all over himself. He grabbed it and he started rubbing it over his head, all over his face, all over his neck. I had to shower him again. He didn't need much help, but I still had to help him get into the shower chair. But when we went to the shower, like, he almost slipped on his own boo-boo. Like, it was just not good. Like, he had it everywhere on his back, so I have had to help him get it off his back, his head. He had it everywhere, and, like, the smell did not go away. It did not go away whatsoever. And, like, I honestly felt like this man was doing this on purpose. The good thing about being a CNA is the bond you build between the families. Like, the care I have for my patients is amazing, and I can say that about myself. I know how amazing my care is for patients and people in general. I love elderly patients. Like, I love elderly patients. I found myself always getting attached to the families, to the patients. The patients' families loved me. I'm not trying to boost my ego, but the patients' families really, really loved me a lot. And I know that for a fact. And it's because when I was a CNA, I provided care as I would to a family member. Like, as I would for somebody that, if I had a family member in the nursing home, I would want them to be treated. I don't see how there's CNAs out here that treat patients like crap, that go in there and don't really shower them, don't really give them a full, proper bed bath. Like, I don't see what's the point of your job. A lot of times you're going to feel like you're unappreciated. A lot of times you're going to feel like people talk to you like you're a robot. Like, there's like 3 to 15 of you. Like, you could be in all these places at once. Like, you could feed all these patients at one time. And you're not going to be able to. You know, it's a very, very multitasking job. But you got to remember that you're one person and you cannot overwork yourself, because you're going to want to quit. You're going to want to walk out. But yeah, it's like a very rewarding job. If you are in school for CNA or if you're thinking about doing it, go ahead and look into it, but make sure that you are ready to work really, really hard, to be mentally, physically, and emotionally exhausted. Make sure that you're going to be able to deal with, like I said, very, very, very strong smells. I don't know, like, just be prepared, you know, to deal with anything and not quit. Don't quit. Keep going. And yeah, so I'm gonna see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to comment down below, like, and subscribe if you are new to my channel. I will see you next time. Bye.